Hello guys, this is Modelman, and today's video is gonna be about first, what pixel is, second, differences and similarities between vector and raster, and third, vector-based softwares and raster-based softwares. So let's get right into it! Before we start, I'm gonna add one more thing. In every episode of Modelman Animation, I usually start from the basics, and sometimes I explain the meaning of some words for you so you could understand them better. Let's take a look at this. Chapter 1. Pixel. Here we are in Photoshop, and I opened a photo of Mickey Mouse. If I zoom in, as you can see, this photo contains a lot of squares. Some of them are black, some of them are white, and some of them are gray. So basically, every part of this image contains these kind of squares, and every square has its own color. We call these squares pixels. So if I zoom out and go to image and image size, as you can see, the unit of this image is now based on inches. We can change it to pixels. Like this. And this image has 634 pixels in its x-axis and 124 pixels in its y-axis. Also, you can change it to whatever you want. For example, I want to change it to 180. Just pay attention to this chain here. If it's on, it means that whenever you want to change this number will be changed too. So I'm gonna type 180, and as you can see, this one is changed to 291. Let's press OK. And now if I zoom in, the number of squares is lower. So this picture has lower pixels than before. One weird question, are pixels always square? The answer is no. We have some pixels that are not square. Here in Adobe After Effects, I'm gonna create a new composition. And as you can see, the type of pixels is set to be a square pixels. I can change it. So for example, this one, it says 2. What is 2? It means that the pixel that you want to create is something like this. So its width is twice its height. That's why it's 2 here, okay? Or for example, this one, it means that the width of the pixel is 1.46 of its height. Just remember that they're not squares all the time. Chapter 2, raster images. And one more thing about this photo is that if I want to change its size by Control T, and make it smaller and confirm. As you can see, the photo doesn't have too much pixels, the same as before. Even if I make it bigger again, the software cannot reproduce those pixels again. So the quality will be too low. We call these kinds of images raster because it contains some pixels and every of those pixels have some colors. If you want to decrease the size, the number of those pixels will be decreased too. And also the quality, I mean. And if you want to make it bigger, you can see there is nothing left from that high quality that we had from the first point. Just keep that in mind. When you want to make an image smaller, as long as you don't confirm, the quality of that image and the number of pixels won't lose. Chapter 3, vector images. Now I'm gonna draw a circle, but this time, instead of an image, I'm gonna use this draw tool here and draw a circle. So by holding down the left click, I'm gonna choose ellipse and draw a circle. It's actually an ellipse, not a circle. By the way, as you can see, this circle has 4 points. We call each one of these points anchor point. When you want to change its size and confirm by enter and increase it again, the quality won't lose. Why is that? It's because the Photoshop always memorizes the position of every point of this shape. And when you want to change its size, the Photoshop is gonna be like, okay, this point up here moved here, this point moved there, and so on. And then it's gonna redraw the whole shape, just like this. As soon as you make it bigger, it will do the same. So the quality will be the same always. Vector images are not just some pixels. They're actually the coordinates of some anchor points. That's why they don't lose quality. Chapter 4. Vector-based softwares. Now take a look at Paint. Here in Paint, I'm gonna draw a circle. As you can see, if I zoom in, we can see those pixels again. In Word, let's draw a shape. With this shape, no matter how much I zoom, the quality won't lose. That's because this software is actually vector-based. It means that no matter how much you zoom, the quality will be the same. In Illustrator, I wanna draw a shape with red color. As you can see, again, no matter how much I zoom, the quality will be the same. Chapter 5, Raster-based softwares. But in Paint and Photoshop, we can see that the quality will lose. To conclude, we can say that Paint and Photoshop are actually raster-based softwares, while Word and Illustrator are vector-based softwares. Just try to think about it for a second. What softwares are raster-based and what other softwares are vector-based? The answer of this question is up to you. As you may have noticed, some software such as Photoshop has some tools that are for drawing raster images and has some tools that are for drawing vector images. If it's a raster-based software, the raster tools are usually upper than the vector tools. In Illustrator, it's vice versa. We have some tools that are for vector drawing and they are upper. We usually use vector-based softwares such as Illustrator to create high-quality artworks. On the other hand, we use raster-based software such as Photoshop because they give us more freedom. For every vector shape, we have to move some points. But in raster, it's not like that. You can freely draw whatever you want. And now, summary of this lesson. Pixels, the smallest unit of every digital image. Raster pictures, by decreasing the size of them, the quality and the number of pixels will lose. Vector pictures, by decreasing their size, the quality won't lose. There are some anchor points that the software memorizes their coordinates. Vector-based software, no matter how much you zoom, the quality won't lose. Raster-based software, if you draw a vector shape in it, as soon as you zoom, the quality will lose. Alright, that's it for this video. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and hit the bell. And ask me if you have any questions in the comment section. I'll definitely check them. And I wanna add one more thing. None of us have been perfect from the start. It's the way that makes us perfect. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.